Now start the first synthetic rubbers, that is the isoprene, and second is the polyisoprene. See, as I have told you in previous video, that each and every natural rubber has an isoprene unit, that is the C5H8N. And C5H8N is nothing but it is the 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene. Okay, and it is a high molecular weight content natural rubber. So here we will discuss how we can prepare in industries by using some different starting materials or by using some different chemicals. Okay, so there is a one method to prepare the isoprene, and that is the isoprene from the propylene. Isoprene from propylene. So isoprene means CH3CH2. When you carry out the dimerization reaction, see, all of you know that it is a pi bond which is a very weaker. So when you carry out this dimerization reaction in presence of different catalysts such as nickel as well as in acidic medium, this pi bond will be break and dimerization take place, so that you will get the molecules like this CH2CH2CH3. Then after, in next step, the isomerization take place and you will get, see, this is the nomenclature of this molecule is 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So this is the 2-methyl-1-pentene. Okay, 2-methyl-1-pentene. But here when isomerization take place, at that time you will get 2-methyl-2-pentene. So why we need to carry out that isomerization? See, here the concept of stability. Once you observe this molecule, then 2-methyl-2-pentene is more stable than compared to 2-methyl-1-pentene. How and why? See, when you calculate the alpha hydrogen atoms means here double bond is present, its alpha carbon contains the hydrogen is known as the alpha hydrogen. So this carbon is alpha carbon and contain the hydrogen is known as alpha position. This is also alpha position. So how many total alpha hydrogens are there? 5 alpha hydrogen atoms are there. But in 2-methyl-2-pentene, you can there is a total 3 and 3 total 6, and these 2, so total 8 alpha hydrogen atoms are there. So we can say that 2-methyl-2-pentene is more stable than compared to 2-methyl-1-pentene. So that's why here we need to carry out that isomerization, so that we get 2-methyl-2-pentene. Then after, we have to carry out its pyrolysis. Pyrolysis at high temperature. Pyrolysis means we have to break that molecule, okay, at very high temperature, so that the CH3 from this one side and H from the other side, and this double bond of that second position will be shifted towards the third position, and this electron will migrate towards the second position, so that you will get the CH3CH2, that is known as isoprene. Okay, so this is the synthetic method to prepare the isoprene from the propylene, which is very simple. You need the starting material as a propylene, you will have to get out this dimerization reaction, then after you will need to get out the isomerization reaction, then after the pyrolysis, so that you will get the isoprene. So this is the isoprene material to prepare the polyisoprene. Our concept is to prepare the polyisoprene. Okay, so now concept is very clear. We need n times of isoprene unit, and we have to carry out this polymerization reaction in the presence of Ziegler-Natta catalyst. Now here, what is this Ziegler-Natta catalyst? Ziegler and Natta, two of the scientists, has discovered one reagent, that is the PaCl3 in AlC2H5TriCl, that is known as Ziegler-Natta catalyst. So in this presence of Ziegler-Natta catalyst, when you carry out the polymerization reaction of isoprene, remember this double bond. See, this double bond is a delocalized double bond. So first, second, third, and fourth. So first and second double bond will be shifted towards the second and third position, and this third and fourth double bond will be shifted towards the fourth position. And then after, another molecule of isoprene will attach from this side, and the final structure will be like this: CH2CH3CH5. double CH, the CH2, another molecule. This is another molecule of isoprene. So many molecules of isoprene is joined and making a one huge molecule, and that is known as polyisoprene. Okay, so this is the synthetic method to prepare the polyisoprene and from the isoprene. And but before to prepare polyisoprene, we need to prepare isoprene. And how you can prepare the isoprene? So we require propylene. So how we can prepare the isoprene from the propylene? So we have to carry out its first step is dimerization reaction. Then second stage is the isomerization. Why we require the isomerization reaction step? Because here the second step is a less stable molecule and third is a high stable molecule. So we require here isomerization. Then after we need to carry out pyrolysis reaction that will remove the methane molecule, and so that you will get that molecule is known as isoprene. Then after the reaction of isoprene in the presence of Ziegler-Natta catalyst, so that you will get the polyisoprene. Okay, and this is the preparation of polyisoprene, and this polyisoprene is used as a synthetic rubber instead of natural rubbers.